Hello and welcome to DC Plus Tutorials. Thank you for joining us. We just started training on Creo Parametric 2.0. Let's continue with 2D sketch. You can access our training tutorial here or links are mentions in description. In this is video I am going to provide you information on how to use constraints and some inspection tool. Constraints are very important in sketch. During sketch, you may notice symbols like H, V, T and R. These are constraints symbols. Draw line and try to make it vertical. You may notice symbol V. Here symbol V stands for vertical constraints. Same way draw horizontal line. You will see symbol H which stands for horizontal constraints. Same way, R stands for equal radius constraints. These way you can also apply constraints while drawing various shape. Let's draw one line and we will use various constraints on it. Select vehicle constraints and then select line. You will see line will convert in vertical line with symbol V. You can delete this constraints by select any constraints and press delete button. Same way you can use horizontal constraints. Click on horizontal constraints and select line. Well, you may face these types of difficulties this because horizontal constraint cannot be applied on vertical line. Same for vertical constraints. What you can do is just make some angle and try to apply constraint. To apply perpendicular constraint, select constraint from toolbar and select first line and then second line. You will notice both lines will adjust it to maintain this constraint. Now let's use tangent constraint. Select tangent constraint and select line and then circle. You will notice, by changing position of line, radius of circle is also changing. These because both have weak dimensions. We will discuss about weak dimensions and strong dimensions in our further tutorials. You can identify weak dimensions by move mouse cursor on any dimensions and information will appears. Now select midpoint constraint and select one endpoint of any entity and select line. Here M stands for midpoint constraint. Same way select equal constraint and select two circle, arc, or line will give you equal radius or equal length. Select parallel constraint and select two line. These selected line will be parallel. Select coincident and select endpoints of entity. Selected point will become coincident. For symmetry constraint, one center line requires. Let's make these two curves symmetric about center line. Here both curve has same number of points, so we will apply symmetric constraints to each control point. Select symmetric constraint from toolbar and select first point then second point and select center line. Same for each control points. Let's analyze this sketch. You might think this sketch is closed sketch, but this actually not. Activate view shaded closed loop tool, you will not find any difference because this is not closed sketch. Now to view open ends, select view open ends tool, you will see two open ends in this sketch. Zoom to this ends and complete sketch. Now you can find the sketch is complete. Now to find overlapping in sketch, select view overlapping. You will find color difference if any geometry has any overlapping. If you have any doubt in sketch commands, you can comment below or write us on other social media platform. Thanks for watching this video. You can appreciate us by your valuable suggestions and feedbacks about this course. To receive update about upcoming videos, subscribe to our channel. We'll appreciate if you share this video. so others can take advantage of this resources. If you like this video, you also would like to see our other video. You can access by clicking here, or links are given in descriptions.